Hello everyone, welcome back to the tutorials again. So today we are going to study about design of concrete structures too. In that, specifically we are going to concentrate on analysis and design of axially loaded column. So you can see over here, in previous session we have studied about introduction to columns as well as types of columns, IS code specifications for columns. Just I would like to revise it and then I will move forward for the examples regarding the design of axially loaded column. So you can see, if a compression member having effective length greater than 3 times the least lateral dimension, then it is called as column. So this is a definition for column. So you can see, normally columns are subjected to axial compressive force, but sometimes it may be subjected to movements on one or both the axis. So column is subjected to the movement in one axis or both the axis. So strength of the column is depending upon the shape, size, cross-sectional area of column and length of the column. So you can see there are different types of column based on the loading conditions. So in that, first type of column is axially loaded column. So when the CG of the load is, center of gravity of a load is exactly coinciding with the CG of column. So this type of column is called as axially loaded column. So you can see second example, eccentrically loaded column, uniaxial loading. So uniaxial loading means, you can see this is the CG of the column. So you can see from the CG of the column, only in x-axis there is a difference in load. There is no distance in y-axis. So it is eccentric only in one axis. So that's why it is called as uniaxial. Similarly, you can see eccentrically loaded column, biaxial loading. So you can see if I load it over here, there is a distance in x-axis also and there is a distance in y-axis also. So distance in x-axis is usually called as ex and distance in y-axis is usually called as ey. We'll move further requirements as per IS 456. So as per IS 456, the requirement for longitudinal reinforcements are as follows. So the cross-sectional area of longitudinal reinforcement shall not be less than 0.8% and shall not be more than 6% of cross-sectional area of column. So minimum, so this is a minimum and maximum percentage of bars for as per cross-sectional area of column is considered. Now you can see minimum number of longitudinal bars shall be 4 in rectangular column and 6 in circular column. The bars shall not be less than 12 mm diameter. So minimum 4 and 6 number of bars in rectangular and circular columns respectively, but in none of the cases longitudinal bars shall not be less than 12 mm diameter. So spacing of longitudinal bars along the periphery should not exceed 300 mm. So we can see further, so this is about transverse reinforcement. In previous slide we have studied about the longitudinal reinforcement. Remember, this is about the longitudinal reinforcement and this is about transverse reinforcement. So transverse reinforcement is given in this manner. So pitch, what is the criteria for pitch, what is the criteria for minimum diameter of bars, everything is given over here, so you can go through it. So you can go through this, all the criteria which I have noted down as per IS 456. So we'll move further. So this is about the ties and this is about the pitches, pitch of the bar. You can see pitch should be least of the following. One is 16 times the diameter of longitudinal bars, 300 mm and diameter. So the diameter, sorry, least lateral dimension of compression member, 16 times the diameter of longitudinal bar are 300 mm. So these three you have to consider. So you can see, so these three you have to consider. By mistake I have highlighted the different one. So you can see these three criteria you have to consider for deciding the pitches. Pitch of the transverse reinforcement. So diameter of the bars, diameter of minimum diameter of transverse reinforcement is nothing but the diameter of lateral links are lateral ties shall not be less than 1/4 of diameter of largest longitudinal bar or 6 mm. So whichever is more we have to consider, but in none of the cases it should be less than 6 mm. Okay, next you can see this is about the pitch which I have said. This is for helical reinforcement. So minimum eccentricity we have to consider, because in site without eccentricity work is almost impossible. So there will be some eccentricity which is induced in a column while it is due to a construction error or man-made error or some other things. Okay, so to counteract that practical part, we need to design the axially loaded column by considering minimum eccentricity. So minimum eccentricity in both the directions should be least of these two, either it is 20 mm or L divided by 500 plus D divided by 30. Okay, next maximum strain and maximum compressive strain and maximum strain in a concrete they have given. So tensile, one thing you can observe here, tensile strength of concrete is ignored. So this is what you have to note down. Next you can see this is the formula, list of formula for design of column. So you can see over here, so PU is equal to 0.446 FCK into AC plus FY, it should be FY into ASC, so 0.87 FY into ASC. So you can go through these formulas. So further you can see this is for helical section. So remember, whatever the things which we are going to calculate as per the previous formula, I have to multiply it with 1.5 times. So it is given over here, you can see I have to multiply it with 1.5 times the strength of column with lateral ties, because if the circular column is having helical ties, the strength will be increased. Further, we will solve a few of the problems. You can see in previous session, you can go through previous session. So in previous session, we have solved the problem on the column wherein we designed the column. For example, I will tell you, just I will open that previous problem. You can see over here, the last problem I would like to open over here. So in this particular problem, you can see what they ask, design the reinforcement. So actually they have given the maximum load, they have given the size. So we were supposed to design the reinforcement. But in this problem, you can see in this particular question, determine the ultimate load carrying capacity. So we need to determine the load carrying capacity here. The load to be carried is given. So this is design type of problem and this is analysis type of problem. Okay, so this is the difference. So determine the ultimate load carrying capacity of a rectangular column section 400 into 600 mm with the 6 number of 28 mm dia bars. Actually, in practical in India, there will be no 28 mm dia bars. So 25 directly 32 mm dia bars we use. Just for problem purpose, I have taken it as 28 mm dia bars. Consider concrete of M25 grade and steel of 415. Assume E minimum is less than 0.05 times the lateral dimension. Okay, so now in this problem, what we need to find? We need to find out PU, that is ultimate load carrying capacity. So this is an analysis type of problem. So you can see, everything is given, we need to carry, we need to find out the load, but here we need to design, we need to design the reinforcement. So this is design type of problem and this is analysis type of problem. So I will move forward. You can see over here, so what are the things which are given? So M25 grade of concrete and Fe415 steel. So FCK I am going to consider it as a 25 newton per mm square. Sorry, I have written it here as a 20, so I need to consider it as a 25 newton per mm square. So further you can see what they have given. FY is 415 they have given. So ASC is equal to 6 number of 28 mm dia bars. So area of steel I have considered as 6 number of 28 mm dia bars. So that is 3694.5 mm square. So area of concrete is gross sectional area minus area of steel. Gross sectional area is 400 by 600 minus area of steel is going to give us area of concrete. So I will move further. You can see over here. So as per IS 456 page number 71, what they have given, consider minimum eccentricity less than 0.05 d. So already they have given minimum eccentricity is less than this, so no need to calculate minimum eccentricity because they have already said that the minimum eccentricity in this particular case is less than 0.05 d. so if this condition satisfies, we can use this particular formula. So same formula we are using as we have used in the previous session. So you can see this is the formula which we have used. 0.4 FCK AC plus 0.67 FY ASC. So it is given in page number 71 of IS 456. So I am using same formula, that is PU is equal to 0.4 FCK AC plus 0.67 FY into ASC, where 0.4 I am writing as it is. FCK is depending upon grade of concrete, that is characteristic strength of the concrete, that is 25 kilonewton. So this is 25 newton per mm square. So area of concrete I have found in previous slide. You can see area of concrete I have found, area of steel I have found. So same I am going to substitute over here. So area of concrete is 236305.5 plus 0.67 into 415 into 3694.5. So PU is equal to 3390.31. So this is the ultimate load carrying capacity. Now in the problem they have asked us to calculate the ultimate load carrying capacity only. So here we can stop. But just for your understanding, if they ask allowable service load, it is we have to divide this ultimate load divided by factor of safety. So factor of safety we are supposed to consider it as 1.5. So allowable service load is 2260.20 kilonewton. So allowable service load we have calculated. So this is one of the analysis type of problem. So we'll move further. You can see I'll try to take one problem from circular section. So determine the ultimate load carrying capacity of a circular column of diameter reinforcement with 6 number of 25 mm dia bars with lateral ties and lateral ties as a spiral. So it is having helical shaped reinforcement. So you can see use M20 grade of concrete and Fe415 steel. Assume that the E minimum is less than or equal to 0.005 d. So here also there is no need to calculate minimum eccentricity which we have calculated here. So no need to calculate minimum eccentricity because already they said that minimum eccentricity should be consider minimum eccentricity less than 0.05 times of lateral dimension. So already they said it, so no need to calculate it. Okay, we'll move further. So FCK is equal to 20 newton per mm square they have given. FY is equal to 415 they have given. Area of steel I am going to calculate. So they have given as 6 number of 25 mm dia bars. So 6 into pi d square by 4. So it is going to give us area of steel. So that is 2945.24. We'll move further. If I want to calculate area of concrete, I have to subtract area of steel in a gross sectional area. So gross sectional area I have calculated pi d square, that is 400 mm diameter they have given. So I guess I have forgot to mention the diameter over here. So diameter of 400 mm. So they have given the diameter as 400 mm. So So you can go through it further. So diameter they have given as 400 mm. Next you can see I have subtracted, I have calculated cross sectional area and subtracted area of steel. So I have got the area of concrete as 1227 18.46 mm square. So this is area of concrete. Next you can see if the column is having lateral ties, this is the formula which we can use to find out the ultimate load carrying capacity. So same formula I am going to use, then I am going to convert it to column with spiral reinforcement or helical reinforcement. So column with spirals are helical reinforcement. So you can see PU is equal to 0.4 FCK into AC plus 0.67 FY into ASE. So same I have substituted, all the values I have substituted, and finally I am going to get the answer as 2046.11 kilonewton. So ultimate load carrying capacity is in case of spiral reinforcement is 1.05 into ultimate load carrying capacity of a section with lateral ties. So it is having lateral ties, and as per a problem they have given as it is carrying the helical ties. So 1.05 into 2046.11, this is as per IS 456-2000 page number 71. So ultimate load carrying capacity of circular column is 2148.42 kilonewton. So this is about the circular section. So same you can go through the problems. So in the problem, these both the problems are analysis type of problem. We are finding the load which can be carried out by the designed member. So already we have designed it, that is already we have provided the number of bars, already we have decided the size, E minimum also we have decided, grade of the concrete also we have decided. Just we are needed to calculate the area of ultimate load which is to be carried by the column. So you can see next problem, design an RCC short column square in section to carry the axial load of 300 kN. Use M20 grade of concrete and Fe415 steel. Assume 1% of longitudinal steel. Unsupported length of column is 3 meter. Sketch the reinforcement detail. So the details which they have given over here is like this. So FCK is 20 Newton per mm square. Fy is 415 mm square. Ag is gross sectional area of column. Is to be found out. So what you can see over here, assume 1% of longitudinal steel, means area of steel ASE is equal to 1% of gross sectional area, means 0.01, you can see over here, means you can see 0.01 means 1 divided by 100 into gross sectional area is going to give us area of steel. So area of concrete is nothing but gross sectional area minus area of steel. So Ag minus 0.01 Ag is equal to 0.99 Ag. So and like that I have made the relation. So you can see the factored load is PU is equal to 1.5 into 300, that is 4500 kilonewton. So PU is equal to 4500. So 0.4 FCK AC, AC I have substituted in terms of gross sectional area, plus 0.67 FY into ASC, so I have substituted in terms of gross sectional area. So AG is equal to 420560.74 mm square. So this is gross sectional area. Sides of square column, so here it should be of, so sides of square column is, as this is a gross sectional area, if I square root it, I am going to get the sides. So provide the square column of 650 by 650 mm. So AG provided is equal to 422500. So according to that, area of steel is equal to 0.1% of gross sectional area. So 0.1% of gross sectional area I have calculated. So provide it according to that area of steel I have found out. So according to this area of steel, I am going to say it as provide 8 number of 28 mm dia bars. Now lateral ties, to decide the diameter of lateral ties, I have to follow maximum of this. So you can see 1/4 of largest diameter, so 1/4 of 28 mm, that is 7 mm, and second one is minimum, it should be 6 mm. So 7 mm diameter of bars we are not going to get, so let us provide 8 mm lateral ties. So with that we have to decide the pitch of the lateral ties. So lateral ties we have calculated, pitch of lateral ties, it should be least lateral dimension, that is 650 mm, 16 times the smallest bars, that is 16 into 28 mm, and either it should be 300 mm. So minimum of these three is 300 mm, so provide 8 mm dia bars, 8 mm lateral ties at 300 mm center to center. Okay, further you can see so we are going to check for eccentricity. So here they have not at all mentioned anything about the eccentricity. So initially only we have to check the eccentricity of the column. So you can see eccentricity is R minimum, that is L divided by 500 plus D divided by 300. So like this, 27.66, so which is greater than 20 mm. Minimum is equal to 27.66. So 27.66 is 27.66 is greater than 20 mm. So E minimum divided by D is equal to 27.66 into divided by 650, which is equal to 0.042, which is less than 0.05 times of least lateral dimension. So I have calculated it in another way, so you can calculate it in this way also. So 0.05 times D, which should be greater than the 27.66 as per our clause. So like this also you can calculate. So what I have done here, so this D I have taken on other side, so divided by I have done. So like this also you can calculate, you are going to get the same answer. Okay, so as this is greater than the minimum eccentricity, or else minimum eccentricity is smaller than 0.05 times D, the design of column is as a short column, and this particular formula which we have used is applicable for the design. So hence it satisfies all the condition. So we have designed it as a short column. So after this, in next session what we are going to do, we are going to see the reinforcement details for axially loaded column. After that we are going to move to the uniaxial design for uniaxial movement. So after that we are going to move to the movement interaction curve. So with those 3 points your unit will be over. So hardly next 1 or 2 sessions are needed to complete this particular unit. Okay, so I am uploading this particular PPT and this particular notes in the Google Classroom, so you can go through it. So thank you, we will continue it in next session.